The second, the first sound, that's the warning signal. The second sound is the sound of the actual duration of the shot. We had a person on this, what you would hear is a wavering tone that would indicate that the person had just gone into a grand mal epileptic seizure.
I gave shot. I didn't have the courage yet not to get shot. I didn't have the courage yet not to get shot. My brain didn't get shot. You can't become a psychiatrist without passing through that ritual of, in a sense, spilling blood that makes you a part of the community of psychiatry. Well, it's a good point. I not only felt I was damaging the patient, I felt like I was bottomizing my own spirit. I felt as if I was doing something terrible to myself. But you're really going to a technician, a technocrat, who has no sense of the human spirit, no sense that human issues are involved in ethical conflicts or personal hurts or spiritual difficulties. The whole concept is we are machines. We are machines. We are machines. We are machines. But the idea is so destructive is that people really are not human beings, that their diseases, you sort of wipe out the discipline, you wipe out the depression, or you wipe out the person. People really are not human beings, that people really are not human beings, that their diseases, you sort of wipe out, or you wipe out the person. Major psychiatric drugs. We now know they cause brain damage. We now know they cause brain damage. Half or more of the patients given long-term treatment, half of them, that the brain should be harmed so that she wouldn't feel so upset. The new psychiatry emphasized that all these problems are biological. We'll repeat it in the newspapers. We'll repeat it in the magazines. Depression is biological. Schizophrenia is biological. Being a woman who's afraid to go out of doors, which has a lot of historical reason to it, that's biological too. And it's all not. Lies repeated again and again to bolster economic reasons the new image that you've got to go to a medical doctor to solve personal problems. Yeah. And it's all lies. But the lies repeated again and again, and it's all lies.
Gracie Point Hospital made $26 million last year, shocking 4,000 people. They used 50 cents worth of electricity.
But God is not a profit-making hospital. So if you look at non-profit-making institutions, profit-making, 20-to-1 ratio in favor of shock. It's the only way that this is a psychiatrist. It's the only way that this is a psychiatrist. And it is done for two women, as Dennis said. And I think that's what the whole society values the brain of women less than the brain of men. It's the whole society values the brain of women.
No, the gentleman's way of brutalizing a woman is perhaps the majority of people undergoing electric shock these days.
Psychiatrists never get that. When they go into a deep depression, they're known to go into deep depression and become suicidal. They have a high suicide rate. They're known to go into deep depression and become suicidal. They have a high suicide rate, but they will not allow themselves to be shot. I found reconstruction of my brain, which was damaged. I found reconstruction of my brain, which was damaged.
This is the most dangerous thing you can do when you're down and out. To go for help in mental health
That's
protection.
That's right.
The dangerous thing you can do when you're down and out is to go for help in mental health
That's
protection.
Right.
You have to be very cautious, and especially avoid anyone who's diagnosing you, offering you drugs, offering you a hospital, or has biology or electroshock attached to the association.
I think it's important now. A 40-year-old woman shot to this way. That if the patient is over 50 or over, dial it to 100%. And this is the duration of the shot for anyone over 50.
Another man lost a leg, and tonight he's in
Joseph Anderson climbed into a trash dump during the 1400 block of Fannin to escape the morning cold. While he was asleep, the dumpster was emptied into a garbage truck. The driver of the truck noticed Anderson's leg sticking out of the hatch of the truck. He opened the hatch and found Anderson inside. He is now in critical condition at Ben Cobb Hospital after having his right leg amputated. The driver of the truck noticed Anderson's leg sticking out of the hatch. The driver of the truck noticed Anderson's leg sticking out of the hatch of the truck. He opened the hatch and found Anderson inside. Another man lost a leg, and tonight he's in critical condition after the tragedy occurred. Squad is now at Herman Hospital. Say a woman lost control of the car, jumped the curb, and struck the parked vehicle, which ran into Vaughn. Another man lost a leg. The driver of the truck noticed Anderson's leg sticking out of the hatch of the truck. Another man lost a leg, and tonight he's in critical condition after having his right leg amputated.